Thank you to everyone who came here tonight to support the State of Israel through a strong Zionist organization of America. A special thanks to the officers and the board members who worked hard to put this event together. I appreciate the beautiful introduction that Rabbi Knopf made for Ruth and myself and Rabbi Rosenberg's invocation. Thanks to Jane Hurley, who did a great job as our dinner chairman. I'm very happy to see all my friends and relatives that are here tonight. My daughter Sherry is here. My other two daughters are living out of the country and could not, unfortunately, be here tonight. My brother Howard and his wife Margie are here. My sister Penny Carden and her husband Alan are here tonight. My brother-in-law Rabbi Earl Blackman and his son Ori are here with us as well.
Wonderful.
Ruth and I are very happy to see you all. I would like to congratulate the other honorees. I remember Andy Williams' father, Hardy, campaigning in Winfield 40 years ago. That shows just how long the Williams family has been serving our community. My wife, Ruth, was released from Bryn Mawr Rehabilitation Hospital today and is very happy to be here. She has asked me to speak for the both of us. I'm just glad that she is here and looking beautiful. I'm not sure why or how the ZOA picked us as the honorees, but I can tell you one thing. In a world as complex as ours, that the ZOA, Zionist Organization of America, has taught us so much. Through the programs they put on and the literature they put out, they have been able to try, we have been able to try to better understand the Jewish world around us and our place in it as supporters of Israel. Our connection with Israel is a very personal thing. My bar mitzvah was 2 weeks after David Ben-Gurion declared the modern state of Israel. I remember how thrilling it was to see the pictures of Israelis dancing in the streets of Tel Aviv. I remember how proud we were to see the IDF win war after war against better equipped and larger armies. I remember how Jewish life changed here. How thrilling it was to see a parade of Israeli Independence Day. I knew Israeli Independence Day in downtown Philadelphia. It might seem quirky, but every year Ruth and I go to the Holocaust Memorial Ceremony on the Parkway. My eyes tear up when I hear the cantor Bumah HaTikvah and see the dignitaries commemorate the Holocaust. Our older daughter, Heidi, was an avid reader. Her heroes were those early Zionists who had a dream for a homeland for the Jewish people. Heidi has been living in Israel for 18 years. She has worked as a writer and supported herself ever since she got to Israel. She wanted to live a Jewish life in a Jewish place according to a Jewish calendar. Heidi left her job at as a newspaper reporter to become an editor of Eretz magazine. I used to tell her when she worked for the Jerusalem Post that she should write a book titled Murder and Mayhem from the Holy Land. Eretz magazine allows her to write about the beauty of Israel, its culture, and its people. Israel is a beautiful country. The other night at Har Zion Temple, Dan Senior presented a program based on how Israel has made major strides in high tech. Israel ranks number 3 after the U.S. and China. He pointed out how miraculous that is given Israel's size versus the other two. Dan also spoke about his book, Startup Nation, which tells the story of Israel's economic miracle. I just hope that you all come away from this evening with a new appreciation of how the Zionist Organization of America and its leader, Mort B.Gleit, are effective advocates for Israel and how Israel and the Jewish people benefits from all of their various activities. Ruth and I thank you all very much.